Sunchal Mohita from Mercy Sandipani. I am your mathematics teacher. I am taking mathematics subject in standard 7. Today we are going to start mathematics of standard 7, chapter number 2, fractions and decimals. So, dear students, first of all, what is fraction? So, fraction is a part of a whole. So, what is meant by fraction? So, your fraction is a part of a whole. It means this is one circle and I have made one equal part of this circle. So, here this is one circle. So, and we made four equal part of this circle. So, here we have to write 4 in the denominator. This is the denominator and upwards it is numerator. So if I shaded this portion and if I want to write the fraction of the shaded portion, so here I have to write 1 upon 4 is the answer. Now fraction. So fractions are of 3 types. First is proper. Second is improper and third is mixed fraction. So, fractions are of 3 types: proper, improper and mixed fraction. Now, what is proper fraction? First number is proper fraction. Proper fraction. So, what is proper fraction? So, when numerator is smaller than denominator, it is called proper fraction. For example, 4 upon 8, here numerator is smaller than denominator. So, it is known as proper fraction. Then second is improper fraction. Now, what is improper fraction? When numerator is greater than denominator. Suppose we are taking this example again. So, here we have to write 8 upon 4. It is 8 upon 4. So, here numerator is greater than denominator. So, it is called improper fraction. Now, mixed fraction. So, now what is mixed fraction? Mixed fraction, here 1 is the whole number. 1 number is whole. For example, here I am writing 4. So, here 4 is the whole number and another along with it there is 1 part. That is 4 1 by 2. This is called mixed fraction. So, here we pronounce this as 4 1 by 2. There are some more examples also, 7 1 by 3. So, this all are considered as a mixed fraction. So, dear students, let's start exercise 2.1. Our first question is 2 minus 3 upon 5. So, here in this, there is nothing in the denominator. So, we have to write 1 here. Now, our question is 2 upon 1 minus 3 upon 5. So, here denominator are the different. So, we have to take the LCM of this denominator. So, 1 and 5. So, here we have to write 1. Okay. So, what is the LCM of 5 and 1? So, now LCM of 5 and 1 is equal to 5 only. So now what we have to do is we have to write the LCM here. So here 1. So we have to multiply it with 5. We get 5. So here we have to multiply it with 5. So if we multiply the denominator with 5, so, we have to multiply the numerator with 5. So 2 5s are, that is 10. So we get here 10 upon 5. Now 3 upon 5. Here in this LCM we have 5, so we have to write 5 here. Now with which number we have to multiply with 5, we get 5 only. So here we have to multiply this denominator with 1. If you multiply this with 1, then only we get 5. So if you multiply the denominator with 1, so here we have to multiply the numerator with 1. So 3 ones are 3. So we get 3 upon 5. Now what we have to do here, we get same denominator. So now this is 10 upon 5 minus 3 upon 5. Now 10 minus 3 upon 5. So now what? 10 minus 3 is 7 upon 5. We get the answer 7 upon 5. Now another question is 4 plus 7 upon 8. So here also we have nothing in the denominator, so we have to write 1. Now take the LCM of 1 and 8. So if we take the LCM of 1 and 8, we get only 8. 2 4s are 8. Here again we have to write 2. 2 2s are 4. Okay, so this is the LCM of 1 and 8. It is 8. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. So now what we have to do, we have to write the LCM over here, that is 8. Now with which number we have to multiply it with 1, we get 8. So here we have to multiply it with 8, we get 8. That is, we have to multiply 8 with the denominator, we get 8. So again we have to multiply the numerator with 8. So 4 8s are, that is 32. Then 7 upon 8. Here we have to write 8. So here in this the denominator is 8. So here we have to multiply it with 1, then only we get 8 here. So if we multiply this denominator with 1, then we have to multiply the numerator with 1. So 7 ones are, it is 7. So here we get 32 upon 8 and here we get 7 upon 8. Now what is the further step is 32 upon 8. Here the sign is plus. So here we have to write plus 7 upon 8. Now further step is 32 plus 7 upon 8. Because we get the same denominator here. So we have to write 32 plus 7 upon 8. Now what is 32 plus 7? That is 39. So we get the answer 39 upon 8. And if we have to convert this into mixed fraction, then we have to do 39 divided by 8. So here 8 4s are 32. So now here 9 minus 2, that is 7. So here we have to write 8 in the denominator and this 7, that is in the remainder form, we have to write here upward and this 4 we have to write in the side. So 4 7 by 8 is the answer. So now another question is 3 upon 5 plus 2 upon 7. So here in the denominator we have 5 and 7. So what we have to do first is LCM of 5 and 7. So here we have to take 5 outside. 5 is a 5, then we have 7. So we get LCM, that is 5 7 is 35. We get 35 LCM. Now 3 by 5 into, here we have to write 35. So with which number we multiply it with 5, we get 75. So here we have to multiply it with 7, then only then we will get 35 here. So if we multiply the denominator with 7, so we have to multiply the numerator with 7. 3 7 that is 21, then 2 upon 7 into, here we have to write 35. Now here in this denominator is 7, so we have to multiply it with 5, then and only we get 35 here. So if we multiply the denominator with 5, so we have to multiply the numerator with 5. So 2 5s are, that is 10. So here we get 21 upon 35, and here that is 10 upon 35. So now what we have to do, 21 upon 35 plus 10 upon 35. Remember this sign, if there is a minus then we have to put minus, and if there is a plus then we have to put plus. Now 21 plus 10 upon 35. So here we get 31 upon 35. So our answer is 31 upon 35. Now number 4, 9 upon 11 minus 4 upon 15. So here we have to take the LCM, that is 11 and 15. So here we have to write it with 3. So in that, here 11 is not in the third table, so here we have to write 11 only, and in 5, so 3 5s are 15, so here we write 5. Then again we take 5 here, 1 and 11. So now 3 into 5 into 11, so 3 into 55, 5 into 11, that is 55. So here we get 165. Now our LCM is 165. So now what we have to do is we have to write 165 over here. Now here in denominator it is 11. So see here, with 11, 3 5s are 15. So if we multiply 11 with 15, we get 165. So here we have to multiply 11 with 15, we get 165. So if we multiply the denominator with 15, so we have to multiply the numerator with 15. So 9 5s are 135. 9 15s are 135. Now 4 upon 15, here again we have to write 165. Now 15, look, 3 5s are 15, so here we have to take 11. In the denominator it is 15, so if we multiply 15 with 11, we get 165. So if we multiply the denominator with 11, we have to multiply the numerator with 11, so here we get 44. So here 135 upon 165, and here 44 upon 165. Now it is in the minus form, so we have to write 135 upon 165 minus 44 upon 165. Now 135 minus 44 upon 165. So here we get 91 upon 165. Now fifth number, 7 upon 10 plus 2 upon 5 plus 3 upon 2. So here we have to take the LCM of these three denominators. So 10, 5 and 2. First we will take it with 2. So 2 5s are here, 5 here, 1. Here 5 and 1, 1. So we get LCM 10 over here. Now 10 upon 7 into, here we have to write 10. So here the denominator is 10. So if we multiply 10 with 1, we get 10 here. So if you multiply the denominator with 1, we have to multiply the numerator with 1. 7 into the 7. So we get 7 upon 10. Then 2 upon 5. Here in the denominator there is a 5. So here we have to multiply it with 2, we get 10. Then here also we have to multiply the numerator with 2 and we get 4. 3 upon 2 into, here in this denominator is 2, so we have to multiply it with 5, and here it is also with 5. So 3 5s are 15. So here 7 by 10 plus 4 by 10 plus 15 by 10. So 7 plus 4 plus 15 upon 10. So 15 plus 4, that is 19, and 19 plus 7, that is 26. So here we have to write 26 upon 10. Now we have to cut this with 2. 2 5s are 10 and 2 13s are 26. So here we get 13 upon 5. Now if we have to convert this into mixed fraction, so we have to write here 5 2's are 10 and 3. So 5 2's are 10 plus 3, that is 13 upon 5 is the answer. Now 6th number. Our 6th number is 2 2 by 3 plus 3 1 by 2, which is given in a mixed fraction. So first of all we have to convert 3 2's are 6, 7, 8, that is 8 upon 3 plus 3 2's are 6 plus 1, 7 upon 2. Now what we have to do, this is in the simple form, so we have to take the LCM of 3 and 2. So here we get LCM, 2 into 3, that is 6. So here what we got, that is 6. 8 upon 3 into, we have to write 6 in the LCM. So here denominator is 3, so we have to multiply it with 2, we get 6 here. So here in numerator there is 8, so here we also multiply it with 2. 8 2's are 16 upon 6. Now 7 upon 2 into, now here 6. So in this the denominator is 2, so here we have to multiply it with 3, we get 6. So here also we have to multiply it with 3. 7 3's are 21. Now 16 upon 6, here plus sign is there, so we have to write plus over here. Now 16 plus 21 upon 6. So 6 plus 1, that is 7, and 3 plus 2 plus 1, that is 3. So we get 37 upon 6. And if we have to multiply in fraction, so what we have to do is 37 divided by 8, 6, 6, 6 are 36. So here in remainder we got 1. Now we have to write 6 in the denominator. Now what we have to do, this 1 remainder we have to write it upward, and this 6, that is quotient, we have to write in the side. So here we get 6 1 by 6. Now our 7th number is 8 1 by 2 minus 3 5 by 8, which is also given in a fraction, mixed fraction form. So now what we have to do, 8 2's are 16 plus 1, 17. So here we have to write 17 upon 2 minus 8 3's are 24. 24 plus 5, that is 29 upon 8. Now this is in the simple form. So now what we have to do is we have to take the LCM of 2 and 8. So this is your homework. So dear student, here we completed our question number 1 from exercise 2.1. So I hope you understand it very well. So keep practicing. Thank you so much.